Imagine that you've got a robot arm that's carrying a cup of coffee, and that arm has no clue whether it should keep the coffee upright or carry it at an angle. Now, you, the human, are the expert. You know what the robot should be doing. And what we're excited about is how we can transfer that human knowledge to this intelligent robotic system. Really, what we're doing is trying to take it from two different points of view, the robot's point of view and the human's point of view. Now, from the robot's perspective, I need to be able to learn from a variety of different humans who might all have different wants, preferences, and desires. Now, from the human's perspective, what I really need is a robot that's very clear and understandable so that I'm kept in the loop and I know what the robot has learned from me and what it's still a little bit confused about. So what we're really thinking about now is users who might have a physical limitation or disability, or even just be inexperienced. They've never really worked with these robots before and are unsure how best to teach that robot what they want. Existing algorithms expect the human teacher to always be perfect, to always show exactly what it is they want the robot to do. Now, we recognize that that's a little unfair to these maybe more naive or just users who don't have that capability. And so what we're trying to do is enable robots to learn from your intentions. Maybe you don't show exactly what you want, but the robot's able to extrapolate and gather, hey, this is what you meant. This is what I should be doing. And then I can help you do that task, even if you can't do it by yourself. So really closing that loop with the humans is crucial because it does two things. First of all, once I know what my robot has learned, I'm ready to deploy it. I'm ready to put it out into the world and actually let it do things autonomously on my behalf. And second, it actually helps me speed up my teaching. Because if I know, hey, the robot understands this part of the task, it knows where to put the coffee mug, but it doesn't understand what angle to carry it, I can focus my teaching specifically on keeping that coffee cup upright. If we take these systems out of their lab and out into the world, they're gonna need to interact with everyday people. And of course, not all these people are gonna be experts in robotics and programming and teaching. So what we really wanna do here at Virginia Tech is make sure that these robots are understandable so that everyday people can show the robot, hey, this is what I want you to do, and use it in their own home.